Hello everyone, Kilikau Divine here playing Football Manager 2017. We are playing with Grasshoppers in the Swiss League, Swiss Super League even. Qatar concerned after Euro Cup draw, we are concerned as well. I can only ask my team to go out and do their best. If that's not good enough, at least we have tried. Qatar is my assistant manager. And we are going to face West Ham. That's going to be a tough one. We have scouted their team. Looks like a very strong team, actually. Oh, this is going to be tough. Before that, I will face Thun. First away game in the league this season. We started out very good, winning against St. Gallen at home. And then we have also won both matches against Sandrijeske. We are getting ready to play. Thun is the favorite today, mostly because they are playing at home. It's quite close according to the odds. Thun lost their first match. Not sure against who. Let's see the starting lineups. They are playing 4-2-3-1. We are sticking with the diamond. Hopefully that will pay off today as well. Let's see the opposition instructions. We're gonna have our Sultan Kadar, our assistant manager, take care of that. And we want to make a speech today as well. Come on, lads, show me what you got. No, I'm expecting you to win today, boys. That's the one we're gonna use. Let's go. Looks like Thun is getting the first highlight of the game. 25 minutes in. Penalty. Oh no, it's a penalty. What the hell happened there? Xavi Munoz caused the penalty right at the edge of the box. And 1-0 Thun. Okay, corner. Maybe we can get a quick reply. Yes, 1-1. Who was that? Xavi Munoz. He caused the penalty, but now he scores the goal. So I guess he is back on good terms with us. Bayrami, new on the field, he's playing his first match, I think, from the start this season. Good, good job. Sukachev shoots, Munoz touches it, and it's a goal. And a second penalty, Marko Basic this time, defending midfielder. Thun gets the second penalty of the game, about 5 minutes apart. Of course, we are expecting another goal here. And yes, it's a goal, sadly. 2-1 Thun, 30 minutes played. Half time, and we are down. We're gonna tell them that the performance have not been good enough. They want us to change Marko Basic and Mario Hermoso. And we're gonna mark... Oh, that's the third penalty. What the hell? Three penalties, and we are not even 47 minutes into the match. 3-1 Thun, and the match is over. 3-1 to Thun, three penalties. How the hell could there be three penalties in the same match for the same team? Ooh, not happy about that at all. Gonna tell them that it was disappointing. And we can see that other than the penalties, it was quite close between us. First loss of the season in a competitive match. Let's hope this will not repeat against West Ham. And of course, after a loss, we need to make changes to the teams. Antonov and Lavanchi are going to play. They were probably going to play anyway. Pnishi is going to go in because Sesiger caused a penalty in the previous game. Basic also caused a penalty. I think we need to keep him while Sigur Jonsson gonna go in. Kaiu is gonna go in. That is how we will play. No, Sokachev is gonna go out for Rich as well. Opposition instructions are done. We're gonna tell the team that they need to perform better than last time. Let's look at the formation West Ham is using, 4-2-3-1. A bit worried about that because that is the one that Tune used, and they got three penalties. So a decently strong team. Let's see if we can match them on the pitch. Free kick, and free kick is a goal because Lanzini managed to score. 1-0 West Ham. We can see the free kick coming here. There we have it, a good free kick. Maybe with a better goalkeeper it could have been saved. Let's see if we can make something happen as well. Please let this be a highlight for us. Long ball by Pnichi, Dabur, and Dabur. What the hell? Looks like this is going to be a very tough match for us. West Ham looks very strong. And we look very, very weak against them. 2-0 and the Carroll. Wow, this is going to be tough. Antonov, maybe you can get something happening here. Nope, not this time. Sigur Jonsson, Basic. Now maybe Lavanchi. Yes, 2-1. Dabur scores, Lavanchi with the assist. We are back in the match. Mansi out to Lavanchi. He goes past the defender, finds Dabur with a lot of space, and he makes no mistakes. Half time, and I feel like we are back in the match. Still, we are down with 2-1, but I feel like if you look at possession and chances, clear-cut chances, we are absolutely back in this match. Hopefully we can get a good start to the match, to the second half. Antonov, Dabur, Antonov, and the ball is lost. West Ham trying to create something, and the Carroll, Arbeloa. They are, oh no, 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 and the Carroll in the middle. And the Carroll in the middle, 3-1 West Ham. That was not the start to the second half we were hoping for. We are waiting for the final whistle. Do not think we will get another chance to score this match. Just a few seconds away now. Should be the end of the match now when he kicks the ball out. And there we have it. We lose 3-1 against West Ham. Even if I feel like we did a good match. If you look at the shots and the shots on target, we are certainly in this match. Ball possession 50%. We certainly could have gotten a better result. 2-1 or 3-2 would have been better. Then I would have felt like we are in a good position. But now it's going to be tough. Can we do anything at home against West Ham? That is the question. So we're playing against Sion. Sion is the big favorite to win this match, which means we have made a few changes to our strategy today. Not big ones, but let's see here. We're going to play counter. We're going to play structured, and we're going to see if we can retain possession. Let's see how that works today. The pressure is all on the opposition. Remind the players of that fact. I think that's fine. Let's see if we can have a good match here. We need it. We really need a good performance. Now, maybe Dabur. Dabur scores. Dabur scores. We were passing back and forth from the midfield. And then we lost the ball, but Mansi took it back and put Dabur into a great position. There we have the break from Mansi, and Dabur scores 1-0. Very, very nice. We have played 25 minutes of the match. Half time, and we are still in the lead. Only one goal separating us and Sion so far. We're going to tell the players to keep it up in the second half. We're going to have the same strategy. You can see ball possession 59%. That have been the key for Sion not creating a lot of chances. First highlight. First highlight of the second half. I was going to say it is our highlight. But then they steal the ball. We take it back. But they keep possession. Oh no. They hit the crossbar. But then Konate got completely open goal. And he can just pass it into a 1-1. Not good. See if we can take back the lead. Basish with the ball, Sigurjonsson, Mansi. Will we find an opening forward? No, Mansi just wastes the ball away. I guess that is better than just losing it to a defender. Free kick with Antonov. We maintain possession of the ball. Barmat, you need to turn around. There we go. And then see if we can find an opening in the middle. Munoz, Mansi, Dabur. Oh, that should have been a goal. Dabur, we need you. Corner kick, Kayu. And they have an easy time getting the ball away. We need to make a few changes. We're going to put in Andresa and we're going to put in Bayrami. And I feel like we need to change Basic as well for Patrick Olsen. Three changes with 10 minutes left to go, I think it was. Now, final kicks of the match. Sion got the ball, but that is full time. The whistle is blown. 1-1. We get a point. The odds were against us. We're going to encourage the team that it was a well-earned point against a tough opponent. Coming into the game, Lavanchi can't play, so it's going to be Juan Valera. Who else do we need to change? We're going to have Panishi sit out this match. Sessiger is going to play. Basic, is he healthy enough? Yes, he is. We need to put in Lucas Andersson. He will be important for us. Rich Mansi and Monas Dabur, we need you to perform well today. We're going to go attacking from the start. We're going to go fluid. And we can maintain possession for this match. See if an attacking football from the start can make West Ham struggle. We need an early goal here, I think. Do not see any changes to the West Ham side today. I think they are using the same one. Opposition instructions. What can we tell the team? We need to tell them something. Passionate. Come on, lads, show me what you can do. That will be the one. Come on, guys, I believe in you. Not a single highlight in the first half. We have zero shots on goal. West Ham have two shots, but only one on goal. So, very uneventful match so far. What can we do to change this? We're going to tell them that we can have revenge today. That's always a positive. We're going to stop retain possession. And let's do shoot on sight. Shoot on sight. We're going to be a bit desperate here. We need that goal. We need two goals, actually. But the first goal might change how West Ham play. And then maybe we can take advantage. 50 minutes played. Maybe this is the chance. Yes! Antonov to Andersen, and Andersen scores. First goal of the season. Only 6 minutes into the second half. This gives us plenty of room. You see, it's touched on the defender. Then Andersen got the ball perfectly. Wow. We are in this match. 1-0, but we need one more goal. That was the first shot on goal for us. Can we keep on pushing forward? Okay, we have 15 minutes left to play. We need to start going gung-ho, all-out attack. Will that change anything? We are not creating any chances. West Ham is too good at defending. They get a corner. I think this corner will be the last thing that happens. They do not even get to play the corner. We lose. We win today, but we lose totally 2-3 for West Ham. Wow. We struggled a lot today. We can see the chances. We have 8 shots, but 1 on target. That was the goal. West Ham didn't create much, but that was enough for them. It was certainly enough for them. We go out of the Europa League, but we can do so with our heads held high. because you lose against one of the strongest teams in the competition. I think West Ham have a good chance to go far in the Europa League. And I'm sorry if anyone noticed we played with Swedish currency up till now, but we have changed it to Euro because that makes more sense. We get some money for our adventure in Europe. We get 100k for reaching the third round, and then we get another 245k for going out. We should have gotten a bit more if we had moved forward, but still good money, which means we are still in the positive this season. And this will be the end of the third episode. Tough day for us today. Tough episode. We lost against Toon. We lost against West Ham. We tied against Sion. And then we won against West Ham. But that was not enough. We lost out of the Europa League qualification. Will we be able to turn it around next time? I hope so. I think I will play a few matches on my own. And I will probably... maybe we'll have some goal highlights or something from the matches. And then I will see you for the matches against Basel and Young Boys.